Do you need a YouTube niche? Today's video is the first in a series helping you rethink the YouTube niche. More importantly, your YouTube niche. Today in part one, I'm gonna be laying out the basics. And when I say basics, I do not mean simple. Some of this is gonna be hard to hear, hard to stomach, but it'll set you up for better success later. It'll help make this confusing topic a little bit more digestible. I've been doing a lot of consulting calls and I've been noticing a lot of blind spots. These are the tools and questions and metaphors you need to think about this topic a little bit differently and increase the chances that you can find the right and healthy fit for you. I wanna invite you to listen to this video not like it's a tips and tricks video. It's not a life hack video. It's not a how to step one, step two, step three video. If you just listen for bullet points and tips and tricks, you're gonna miss a lot, and I don't want you to miss anything. This series is gonna be one of the most helpful things I've ever made. Okay, enough talking. Buckle up, let's get into it. For those of you I haven't met yet, I'm Eric Wen, and on this channel we talk about communication and self-awareness. I wanna help you as a creative think about what you say and how you say it so that you can make a better impact. The first tool I wanna share with you guys, I call the art impact ratio. The first thing I often ask during my consulting calls is, when you make your YouTube videos, deep down, are your priorities and personal fulfillment and happiness leaning more towards personal expression, making art, being yourself, or is it leaning more towards, I wanna help people, I wanna reach people, I want to make an impact? Each of us obviously cares about both of those things. We want to be creative, we want to be ourselves, we want to express ourselves, but we also want to reach people, inspire people, and help people. But clarify your ratio. Is it 60% personal expression, 40% impact? Is it 70% making an impact, 30% personal expression? You see, the more you lean towards personal expression, making art, the less you need to worry about having a YouTube niche. If you're happy and fulfilled being yourself, expressing yourself, making art, then the views and the growing on YouTube shouldn't matter as much to you. If you accidentally inspire and impact someone with your art, awesome, but your top priority is being yourself, expressing yourself, and so your channel is going to look accordingly. Now, on the other hand, if you find yourself leaning more towards wanting to make an impact, wanting to reach and help people at scale, then you're going to need to make some sacrifices. You're gonna need to make some compromises with your content. It should be less of a priority to you to be free, limitless personal expression, and instead your priority should be, wait, how can I make my content as helpful and valuable and clear as possible to my audience? This is a sliding scale. It's a mixture. It's a balance. You can't have personal expression be your number one priority while also having personal impact be your number one priority. Deep down, you're driven by one of those more than the other. And the more honest you are with yourself about what your personal ratio is for you right now, the more insight you'll have on what you should do next with your channel. For some of you, that might mean letting go of your niche so that you can be more free and happy. For others of you, it might mean more sacrifices and compromises so that you can reach a broader or more specific audience. It's so common for us to think, oh, I care about both of those things, personal expression and making an impact. Yes, you probably do care about both of those things, but just because you care about both of those things doesn't mean that ratio is 50-50. Your ratio is not 50-50, and if you're stuck thinking that your ratio is 50-50, you're gonna be really confused about what to do with your content. The second idea I want you to get super familiar with, I'm gonna call the YouTube smoothie metaphor. As soon as any of us get semi-serious about YouTube, we start bumping into two big questions a lot. Big question one, who actually am I? What are all the little things that I have to offer? What exactly am I bringing to the table? Big question two is, how can I package and present those things in a way that actually stands out on YouTube? It doesn't work to tackle both of those huge questions at the same time or to pretend like they're both the same thing. In order to not drive yourself insane, you have to treat both of those things as two separate problems and tackle them in the correct order, part one and part two. This is the number one blind spot area of pain and confusion and frustration that I see when I talk with other creators. When you try to tackle both of those big questions at the same time, you mess everything up. You can't really do it. On top of that, if you try to rush through big question number one to get to big question number two, you also mess everything up. This is where I want to talk about smoothies for a second to make things a little clearer. There's a big difference between making a smoothie and selling a smoothie. You shouldn't worry about packaging or branding or selling your smoothie if you don't even know if you like making smoothies yet, if you don't even know how to make a smoothie yet, if you don't even know what ingredients you have. You'll drive yourself insane if you're trying to juggle how to stand out on YouTube, how to sell your smoothie, before you actually know what ingredients you're working with, who you are, what you bring to the table. I believe that every single person has access to hundreds of interesting ingredients, but I think it takes time sometimes to find them, or to discover them, or to save up and buy them, or to like plant them and wait for them to grow and then farm them. If you make your smoothie too early, chances are higher that your smoothie will be exactly like everyone else's smoothie. If you try to become an expert smoothie maker too quickly, there's a higher chance that you'll be freaking out, looking at your competition, looking down at the ingredients you have and feeling like you don't have enough. Wait, that person has 3 grapes, that person has 12 strawberries, wait, where did that guy get a cucumber, I don't know. The longer you take practicing your skills, finding your voice, getting to know yourself, learning about what ingredients you have, or rediscovering some secret ingredients you forgot about in your sock drawer or in the back of your cabinet, the higher the chance that people will taste your smoothie and immediately, instantly feel, whoa, there's something different going on here. Separate part 1 and part 2 and do them in the correct order. Take the time to figure out all the ingredients you have to make a smoothie before you worry about selling your smoothie. The more you're patient with part 1, the more success you're probably gonna find with part 2. The easier it'll be for you later to sell your awesome smoothie. Okay, the final idea I want to tackle in this video revolves around that question of, how much can I mix things up with my YouTube channel? Some of you really are dying to be scattered on YouTube, to combine a whole bunch of different passions and interests and styles and formats with your channel. There are examples of that working, and we're gonna touch on it a little today and a lot in the next part and more in the following part. But just because other YouTubers are doing it doesn't mean you should definitely be doing the same with your YouTube channel. If you're eager to be scattered on YouTube, one, why? Is it because you're not willing to make compromises? Is it because you're not willing to sacrifice some things? Letting go of some of those topics that you like talking about on your channel, it's not about limiting yourself because that's the rules or the algorithm's doing that to you. It's about having more empathy for your audience and wanting to clarify things for them so that your videos are more helpful and more effective for them, the people you care about, right? You really don't want your audience to be confused or put off when they watch more of your videos. Not showing every single side of you on YouTube is not being inauthentic. Now, there are ways for you to have multiple topics and styles and formats on your channel and for it to still work. But the more scattered your interests, the more work you have to put in into making it all make sense for the viewer. That could be with your storytelling, that could be with your messaging, that could be with the through lines and patterns that you've worked into your content. If you're gonna go this wide, you have to put in a lot of extra work to make it not feel so wide. If you can't quickly and clearly explain how these pieces on your channel fit together, then your audience is gonna be confused also about how your channel fits together. And you can't just say, I am the through line, I am the one thing that ties all of my channel together. That's true, you are one major through line on your channel, but if you're gonna go this wide, you're gonna need more through lines than that to make things more clear and digestible for your audience. For me, it's actually freeing to not think about the YouTube niche like it's this one broad topic that has to touch all of my content. Instead, I like thinking about a hierarchy, a pyramid with layers that build on top of each other. Each layer is a genre or topic or style that each has a distinct priority level. The layers are all connected and become more specific and subtle the higher up the pyramid you go. For instance, Casey Neistat would have vlogging as his biggest, most obvious layer. But then more specific from that is filmmaking, travel, tech, his sort of DIY raw style. All those different topics aren't just random on his channel. There's a hierarchy there. There's a different priority level for each of those different layers. They're actually connected. They build on top of each other. Think about that a bit before next video. We're gonna be talking a lot more about the hierarchy and the rest of this series.
Thank you guys so much for watching. Hit that like button, subscribe if you haven't already, share with a friend if you think it could help them today. I'm very excited to see you in part 2. You are the change maker of your own life. Let's think more deeply. I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace, bye.